Right, so let's see what we have in here. Yes, indeed. We've got the Roger Mayer 256 HD. Let's slip that box open. Instruction manual, which we'll read in a little bit. And here we go. Oof. Very nice. Nice feeling build quality. There's what's on the inside. Nice. What else is in this box of goodies, I wonder? Well, let's put that one back in there for now. Oh, and this is something else. What might this be? Sam and his ruthless packaging. Oh, good lord. Interesting. What a cool looking unit this is. All step controls. Nice. Good times. All right, let's get them hooked up. Hey guys, and welcome back to the channel. Now, thanks to Sam at Make Noise Pro Audio, today we're doing a little bit of a tape shootout. So I have, for comparison purposes, or to give you an idea of what these devices do, I've got the Roger Mayer 456 HD in 500 series, two of them, and I've got a Handsome Audio Zulu as well. So we're gonna have a look at how do they sound, how do they compare, yada, yada, yada. And I think I'm gonna throw into the mix as well, the Universal Audio Studer A800. That's my go-to tape plugin, and I'm familiar with how it sounds, so let's stick that in the mix as well, because that's kind of what the Rogers are going after anyway, the Studer with the 456 tape. We can do that with the UA, and we can definitely do that with the Zulu, so let's jump in and take a look at them. All right then, so first things first, let's start with the Studer A800, right? This is the baseline. The song I'm working with today is called Image of Grace by the artist Leah Rye, and it's a song that I've just finished mixing. Now, with this song, I mixed it through the Roger Mayers to get an idea of how they will like to just work through them rather than just slap them on a mix you've already done. So, but I was A-B-ing between the UA plugin and the Rogers the whole time. So let's have a listen what the UA sounds like. So we've got this set to 30 IPS, driving the input just a little, 456, calibration's on +6, and the output's down a little bit. Here we go. Alright, and then if we turn on the Rogers. It's a bit ironic, or even funny how, as one who's empathetic, you never really get it. I'm sorry for being out of touch. I'm not the one that's dragging you across. I'm back again. And back to the Rogers one more time. It's a bit ironic, or even funny how, as one who's empathetic, you never really get it. I'm sorry for being out of touch. I'm not the one that's dragging across. Now, you may notice that I've got a trim plugin after the Rogers, which I have, and it's adding +6. Now, the reason for that's because the input and the output of the 456 HD is unbalanced, so you get a 6 dB level drop. another thing to keep in mind. However, what would have been the 33609, I've taken the cables out and stuck them in the Zulu. So let's put the Zulu in, and I'm having to trim it again. Another, that's 12 dB boost out of the Zulu, so it is a significant level drop if you're using this. But let's have a listen to what the Zulu does. And again with the Rogers. Now, of the two hardware units, they are, to me, or to my ears at least, distinctly different, yet the same. So, I've got the Zulu, as I said in the intro, set to 456 and Studer mode to try to get it as close to the Rogers as possible to give it a fair throw of the dice. Now, what I'm hearing in the Zulu is it sounds a bit more 3D. It sounds a bit more silky, and it sounds a little bit more leathery. It's got, I guess that might be the compression, that definitely on the snare, it sounds a bit more punchy almost. The Rogers, conversely, they seem to be pushing a little bit more high-end, and they do have a very similar compression characteristic, but to me it's like if the Rogers were a 7, the Zulu would be an 8 or a 10. It's a little bit better in the Zulu. Let's listen again. This is the Zulu. And if we switch back to the Rogers. The Rogers seem to be bringing the bass out just a little bit more, and we're splitting hairs. It's not super obvious, but the bass note is lifted a little more, which I guess would be mid-range or lower mid, is definitely pushed a little more in the Rogers. Conversely to all of those, the Studer A800, now we've discussed that, listen again. See, that sounds much more like the Rogers to me. It pushes that bass note a little bit. The thing that the plugin's lacking is the sense of 3D space and the depth. It's not bad. It's really not bad. If you want that tape flavour, the A800 plugin is a good way to go if you can't or don't want, if you can't afford the hardware or you don't want to buy the hardware. The A800 is solid. That's Mixbus duties, right? Let's flip this over and listen to just the drums. I know a lot of people out there who've done tape reviews do it with a whole mix and drums. Now, given the fact that we're emulating tape here, we're not reinventing the wheel. So let's not reinvent the wheel. Let's have a look at drums next. All right, so A800, same settings as the bus. Let's hit it on the drums. Nice. Zulu. Nice. Rogers. The first thing I'm hearing there, the kick is a little bit tighter in the Zulu. The Rogers seem to be saturating a little bit more, and the kick sounds a bit more HD, for want of a better word, through the Zulu. Again, the studio's doing an admirable job, but it's just not as good as the hardware units. They definitely pip it 100%. If I had to pick between the two, I mean, if budget wasn't an issue, I'd probably buy both, to be honest. I'd maybe use the Zulu on the whole mix and maybe the Rogers on the drums. And it does say in the Roger Mayer manual that, you know, they would recommend buying multiple Roger Mayer 456 500s and putting them all in a rack so you could have, you know, like every channel during tracking. And that's the thing with tape, generally speaking. It's a cumulative but subtle process. So if you were to own some Roger Mayers or indeed a Zulu, what I would suggest you do is track through them right from the get-go. I would show you the Roger Mayers, but there's not much to them really. Three dials on the front. I'll show you some B-roll of them in a bit. However, the Zulu. What's cool about this? Well, the first things first, on the back, you've got balanced I/O, as well as four different calibration settings. Now, these allow for different amounts of headroom and vibe and saturation and that kind of thing. So messing about with them gives you different tonalities. Now, the user manual is cool and it tells you everything that you need to know about how to operate this device. So if you need to know more, read the manual. The top section, this is your deck. So in here, you have an option of low, pro, high, and bypass. What this basically means is low is four track cassette tape. Pro is a famous Japanese deck. Any guesses on what that might be? High, which is the one we're really focusing on today, that one is a famous Swiss deck, also known as a Studer. And then the fourth position is bypass, if you just want to use the transformers which are inside this. Now, this is a weighty beast, but you may have noticed it does not have a power supply on the back. It's actually passive. Now, that's cool, but it does come with a bit of a pain in the ass, which means a level drop of about, I've noticed, anywhere between 5 and 10 dB level drop. You can make it up with the trim plugin after the fact, which I will do, but something to be aware of. The next thing you've got is your bias. So you can go all the way from negative all the way around to fully positive, and the last stop is again a bypass. For the purposes of today's demo, I've got it set to plus. Next one down is the enhance knob. This goes from 0 to 100. This changes the characteristics of how much compression is applied, low bump, mid bump, that kind of thing. Tone shaping, if you will, within the tape. And the next one is headroom. Low, pro, and high you have available to choose from. This is exactly what you think it is. It's the amount of headroom available before distortion and clipping occurs, or well, tape distortion. So I have it set to pro, which is middle of the road, because I want to be able to drive snares into it and things like that and get a little bit of break up, but I don't want the whole mix to sound like, you know, distorted. So pro's a good angle for that. High would be super clean, like you'd really struggle to make that distort, and low is obviously significantly lower and it's much easier. So that is the Zulu. May as well give a little bit of a branding shout there. Make noise pro audio. Thanks, Sam. All right, so we've had a look at the Zulu and the Roger Mayers on general settings across mixes and across a drum bus. Now, I want to dive down a little bit deeper and put them through the paces on drums. And let's play around with some settings and see how they sound. In terms of versatility, the Zulu definitely takes the cake. You've got different tape machines, different modes, different headroom ranges and things like that, and you can really kind of shape the sound exactly as you want it to sound, from super distorted to very clean. The Rogers are a bit less versatile, having only the one tape deck and the one tape formula, but that being said, when you push them hard, they sound absolutely, absolutely gorgeous. Alright, so there's my roundup and overview of the tape emulations. Anyway, I hope you've enjoyed the video. I hope this helps any of you that might be out there looking for what the Zulu does or the Roger Mayer does. Thanks a lot for joining me, and until we see each other again, be well. Take it easy.